Adam was a super being when God created him. I don't know whether people even know this, but he was the first superman that really ever lived. First of all, the scriptures declare clearly that he had dominion over the fowls of the air, the fish of the sea, which means he used to fly.
Whoa.
Well, of course, how can you have dominion over the birds and not be able to do what they do?
Whoa.
Actually,
I mean, wait a minute.
I'll prove it to you.
Wait a minute, Benny.
I've never heard that.
The word dominion
in
the Hebrew clearly declares that if you have dominion over a subject, that you do everything that subject does. In other words, that subject, if it does something you cannot do, you don't have dominion over it. I'll prove it further. Adam not only flew, he flew to space. He used to be, he was with one thought, he'd be on the moon.
There's a danger, I think, when we get involved with, you know, Zinn says this, Wessel says this, but I'm going with my guy. My guy, you know, he's just as smart as Zinn's and Wessel's any day. And we're not asking you to pit us against your guy. We're asking you, please, go to the scriptures. Go to the Testament, go to the verses, go to the chapters, read it for yourself. All this literature that Larry has is just absolutely invaluable to you. Read Copeland, read him, read these guys, see what they have to say. Look at their writings, look at their conclusions, look at the anecdotal evidence of what they are saying and what's going on in their so-called communities of faith. Read the Roman Catholic Catechism. Read what they're saying. Read what modern evangelicals are saying. Read what the liberals are saying. And I implore you, if you have any sense whatsoever and call yourself a Christian, your conscience is to be bound by the Word of God.
Amen.
And a careful study
Amen.
Of it. Boy, See, without
and,
that, we
and
are
That is great trouble. Advice, but unfortunately, I think most people are spiritually lazy. That what you're talking yeah. about takes a lot of work.
Yeah.
And most people don't want to do that. They want to just have some spiritual leader and just whatever he says goes. That makes it nice and easy. They don't have to do any extra work or study,
yeah.
and they'll end up going all the way to hell.
Yeah.
And the very second you're in hell, you're going to wish you were back here and had followed, study the Word of God. You will be wishing you had taken the time to read the Word of God.
Could we not say this as well?
Mm.
If there is a whole group out there that has said, okay, I've tried the Baptist, I've tried the Presbyterians, I went to Mom's Methodist Church, and it's dull, it's boring, it's dead, they teach me nothing. We go to Sunday school class, and we sit around, and we give our opinion, we sit in a circle, we hold hands, we're not taught anything. And then one day, my Pentecostal charismatic friend said, come with me. You want to see the Holy Spirit in action? You come with me. And I went, and I saw life, and I saw vibrancy. And I saw, man, I got into this. I, you know, wow.
You got the
I
show in the circus.
I caught the show. And in there somewhere, Larry, there has to be a chastisement and an indictment if this is going on in American Bible-believing churches. We've got a responsibility to teach people. We've got a responsibility to make the Bible interesting. We've got a responsibility to make it come alive, to not be afraid. You're not afraid to dig.
Right, I love it.
It's a labor of love. I mean, folks, this guy is all over it. I mean, he reads, he digs, he takes time. But you're perhaps one in a million. And I'm not saying that everybody out there has to be that thorough, but really, you've got a responsibility. If you're a pastor, if you're a teacher, if you are a Sunday school teacher, get in. We're in a battle for your people. You're in a battle for the gospel. We're in a battle for a very life of evangelical Christianity. We're being steamrolled by the ecumenical movement, steamrolled by the Pentecostal charismatic movement, steamrolled by the liberals. And if you're just deadening your church with long, drawn-out, boring sermons, no Sunday school teaching to speak of, and you're just killing the vegetables on the vine, I want you to seriously consider changing your ways. You can't compete with the show, but boy, by God's grace, you can be a good, solid Bible teacher.
That's right. Be faithful to the Word.
Faithful to the Word. Preach the Word in season and out of season, and do it and take time and take effort. and make it your goal to saturate your people with the Word of God, and they will grow. That is their growth. Mm-hmm. Sanctify them in truth. Thy word is truth. So just somewhere in there, there has got to be a lousy connection between the wonderful truths of Scripture and the things that we can teach Christians about the Bible and how to use the Bible and how to be good apologists and how to defend the hope that's within them. Mm-hmm. And the migration that apparently all these people are just giving up and they're headed off to these wildly insane Pentecostal.
You know what's interesting group. About all that? And you listening to you made me think of it. I wasn't really going to talk about it, but when I first got saved, I got saved reading my mother-in-law's Roman Catholic Bible. Mm-hmm. I was reading one of Hal Lindsey's books.
And I was great planeter.
Well, I read that one already, and I read several others, and I'd done the sinner's prayer, and I was praying every day. I was all nervous. You know, I was being in that drawing stage by the Father, but I wasn't saved yet. Anyway, I'm reading one night on May 16th, 1981. I'm in the living room. My wife's talking to her parents in the other room, but I was into this Bible prophecy stuff. So I was looking up the verses, and I saw, I think it was Timothy, where it says, in the last days, men will be lovers of pleasures rather than lovers of God, and all these things, you know, boasters, proud, disrespectful to parents. And right. I'm sitting there going, yeah, I'm sort of like that, you know, but I'm not that bad, I don't think, you know, although I knew I committed every one of those. But anyway, I got down to the last one, and it said, having a form of godliness, but denying the power.
Right.
And that's where I got convicted of my sin. I started crying for 10 or 15 minutes, and I was crying out. I realized I was lost. Yeah. I was crushed, and I was born again right there. But what was funny is right after that, I'm all on fire for God. I'm reading the Bible. I only had a part-time job, 17 hours a week at that time. And when I got saved, it was right after, 2 weeks after I took my last final exam at UT to get my graduation diploma from UT, University of Texas. I had lots of time to read, and I get born again, so I start reading the Bible like crazy. I can't get enough of it. Yeah. 12 to 16 hours a day, except on the days I had to go to work. And then first thing I want to do is I need to find a church.
Right.
So I go out that first weekend. I think that was like on a Monday night, so I couldn't really go to a church until the end of the week or something. So on Sunday, I heard that there's this church nearby where we were staying at the time, near my in-laws, called the World of Pentecost. But see, I'm so new at being a real Christian.
Right, yeah.
I didn't know any better. And I'm all in a honeymoon period, like I'm just on fire for God and for Jesus, you know, and all that. So I go there that Sunday, and you know, they had the strobe lights like you see in a discotheque. Of course, we're old enough to remember what a discotheque was like, but it's like you find in a dance hall, and they had the rock bands. And so, you know, they're turning off the lights, the strobe lights are going everywhere, the rock bands singing these Christian rock songs, and everybody's speaking in tongues all over the place. I'm hearing all that stuff, and preacher gets up there and he preaches, and he's sweating up a storm and having to wipe himself.
If you like our YouTube channel, please subscribe by clicking on the subscribe button, and then by also clicking the bell above to get an automatic update whenever we produce another YouTube video for our See Answers TV channel. Please share our videos with your friends and relatives. May God bless you. Only one life will soon be passed. Only what is done for Christ will last. To see the full-length video, please select by tapping on the first screen to the right. To see the entire playlist where this particular video is found, select by tapping on a touchscreen on a cell phone or by clicking on a regular computer. The second screen to the right.